Many of us, thousands of us, have either gone through cancer of the various forms in parts of our body and the treatments needed to help beat the cancer as best we can. Many of us live with the after effects of the treatments after cancer and wait and hope that it will not return. Many of us have seen our loved ones suffering with cancer. We have seen our dearest of friends, siblings, parents, children with cancer. And we have sat at their side and we have held their hand. And even though perhaps inside we don't feel positive, we never show it. We talk of normal things, find humour to laugh about, because humour gives us wings of hope and laughter and love and releases serotonin. And if the person we love is suffering with cancer, we can, if they wish, talk honestly with them and ask them how they are feeling. They may choose to tell you, they may not. That is their decision. We do not bully them, harangue them, tell them they're not trying enough. We support them, we love them, we hug them where needed. This has been especially difficult during the last 2 years of the pandemic, when many of us have had to talk to our loved ones through the cameras on our phones when they are in hospital receiving treatment. But we will persevere and we will support each other, and that is what is lacking, I see, especially over the last few hours. I should like to read a poem by Maya Angelou called Still I Rise. You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still like dust, I will rise. Does my sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom? 'Cause I walk like I've got oil wells pumping in my living room. Just like moons and like suns, with the certainty of tides. Just like hopes springing high, still I will rise. Did you want to see me broken, bowed head and lowered eyes, shoulders falling down like teardrops, weakened by my soulful cries? Does my haughtiness offend you? Don't you take it awful hard, 'cause I laugh like I've got gold mines digging in my own backyard. You may shoot me with your words, you may cut me with your eyes, you may kill me with your hatefulness, but still like air, I will rise. Does my sexiness upset you? Does it come as a surprise that I dance like I've got diamonds at the meeting of my thighs? Out of the huts of history's shame I rise, up from a past that's rooted in pain I rise. I am a black ocean leaping and wide, welling and swelling. I bear in the tide. Leaving behind nights of terror and fear, I rise. Into a daybreak that's wondrously clear, I rise. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave. I am the dream and the hope of the slave. And I rise, and I rise, and I rise. Things have got worse. People use the smallest, stupidest excuses to hurt. The world is in turmoil. There is war in Ukraine, for which many of us are trying to support and help in the best way that we can. By gathering supplies and sending friends across the channel here in the UK to get as near to the borders to try to bring people back, elderly people, disabled people, children, wounded people. Or at least just to give them something to eat if it's not possible to bring them back. Show your humanity, however small it might seem to you. Stop the pettiness, the drama on here. Although I cannot see it happening, sadly. There is a world out there. And there is a world in here. On social media, and it is real to many people on social media, regardless of what some try to say. We need to cleave together, we need to look after each other, we need to look after our children. The internet is forever. And whatever we say today, even if we may delete it, remove it, we all know that it is still there. Think of the missing children who, if they are found and grow up, come back and have access to the internet. And they hear the voices of their parents, their aunties, their uncles, their grandparents, whatever. Talking and shouting and screaming about stupid, petty nonsense. Can you imagine thinking that your parent is one thing and then hearing them talking viciously to somebody else? Of course, we don't all get on. But the one thing we all have in common, or should have in common, is our humanity, regardless of where we come from, where we live, our ethnicity, our background. We are all human beings. And we need to start thinking like human beings with hearts. Take care, carry pink.